Hey everybody, Trevor Noah here, and today I'm coming to you from Sydney, Australia, where I'm going to be having a fascinating conversation with Dr. Al-Rahim Habib, the lead at Drumbeat.AI. This is an organization that aims to revolutionize the treatment of ear disease in Indigenous communities. Children in Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander communities have the highest rates of ear disease in the world. And if this is left untreated, it can lead to hearing loss that is permanent and language impairment, which affects them for the rest of their lives. So the question for us today is, how can we use AI to predict, identify, and even treat ear diseases, specifically in communities that are both rural and remote? This is fun, man. Being with you in Sydney, Australia, you know, having a conversation that really, I think, experiences some of its most groundbreaking work here, but is going to impact the world. There are children around the world struggling to live full lives because they don't have their hearing when that could have been prevented. Why is this?
In Australia, we have anywhere from 20 to 80% of Indigenous kids have ear disease. And it's sad because there's a domino effect. If hearing gets impacted early on, it has an impact on your school performance, your future employment opportunities. And that's why we're so focused on trying to get involved early to hopefully prevent ear disease becoming hearing loss. If we can look in more ears and empower people to look in ears and have an AI-supported tool that helps them understand what they're seeing, we're off on the right foot. Because now we can diagnose things much earlier, get involved early in their lives to hopefully prevent ear disease becoming hearing loss.
It seems like it's all just about getting a child in front of a doctor. So why is something so simple so difficult to prevent?
The challenge is that not all ears are the same. And so as a medical doctor, you take time building that pattern recognition in your mind. But someone who is in a rural community doesn't get that same chance. Some of these people have to transfer all the way over to a tertiary center.
So in Australia, you have an Aboriginal population out here where the communities may live where they don't have the specialists and they may not have access to the medical facilities. How do you then bridge the gap?
What we can then do is enable them, get them to the next level. So, well, what if a specialist caliber assessment was mixed with that ear camera? Well, then you can still get that same assessment capacity as you'd get in urban Sydney. For people to stay home, to be able to live in their community which can service them, that's empowerment. That's what we want to see.
Want to see some of the work that you're doing?
Let's do it. All right. This is a photo of the ear. Tell me what you think.
Looks healthy, a little bit of wax, that's always good.
Yeah. Now, what about this? You're seeing something else?
Oh yeah, here. There shouldn't be bubbles. I don't think there should be bubbles in anybody's ear.
What about something like this?
Oh, that doesn't seem good.
Do you know where the eardrum is?
No, there is no eardrum.
And so this is chronic suppurative otitis media, and that's when you start getting more long-term issues with hearing. But we've created a tool called Drumbeat.AI. That has learned over 10,000 images, over 4,000 kids in over 100 different Indigenous communities. And we've been able to train the model to interpret that photo. You see this child come in, And you think, I could use a bit of help. But that might take hours, days, maybe even weeks to get an answer. What if you can get an answer now? Like, what if AI could help you understand what's going on in that ear now?
Okay.
And so now we can press the button here, and instantly we can get an abnormal eardrum that's perforated. That's likely chronic otitis media with discharge absent. It's making a prediction, and that's really important because then you can decide, do I need treatment? Mm-hmm. Do I not? Can I flag this child to see back again in the next couple weeks to see if that hole is healed? And if it's not, you can get another prediction and then make a plan to escalate that to a referral to a GP or even to an ENT. So this is one of our ear cameras.
Okay.
And we have a look, and that's the eardrum. And you can snap a photo.
And that's it.
That's it, that's my eardrum. Let's have a look. Let's analyze it. Normal ear.
Were you nervous for a second?
I was.
You never know. Just now you get like a bad reading and then. This is phenomenal. You just took the picture, got the diagnosis immediately, and you've blown my mind. I need this in all of my doctor's visits now. I'm gonna tell my doctor, this is taking far too long. Should be 5 seconds, take a picture.
Ready to roll.
And I'm ready to roll.
Ready to roll.
Thank you again. Yeah. This is amazing. Pleasure.